speaking with Greg Miles this morning from Caspin Resources. Greg, good morning.
Good to see you, Andrew.
Good to speak, Greg. You've got the results here from some additional drill hole assays from the Duchess prospect, further emphasising the rare earth potential here at the project.
Absolutely.
Tell us a bit more.
Absolutely. I will. Look, I think, so we alluded to this in the initial rare earth discovery, that there was a subsequent batch of samples that we were assaying for the full rare earth suite. And sure enough, these have come back with some really interesting rare earth grades as well, which just supports that Duchess prospect as having that potential for enriched rare earth mineralization. And it's worth noting that between the sort of the two areas that we have sampled or assayed for so far, that's over 2.5, well, between holes is about 2.5 kilometers. So it's a pretty big area. Those drill results are kind of in line with our expectations. We, as you would expect, we assayed the best things first, and that, you know, it's not to say we couldn't necessarily get a surprise, but we're still really thrilled that even away from what we thought was the best area, we're still getting elevated mineralization. So that's very promising.
You've also had some significant rock chip and soil sampling results here.
And I think this is really the bigger story, to be honest with you, because now we're talking about a much larger search space, exploration search space. So we've demonstrated, you know, admittedly, well, in terms of the rock chips, admittedly a small data set. So when we were rock chipping, we were probably looking for other things. But again, put some of those more interesting samples back through the lab. And to get 0.5% in some of those rock chips is really good. Recognizing that we're not necessarily expecting the best rare earth mineralization to actually be outcropping. We expect it to be within the weathering profile. So that, you know, gives us a lot of confidence that elsewhere in the project area, we are going to see some rare earth mineralization. And I guess further to that, the soils data. So we've just used three elements to sort of map what we think might be the rare earth, the best rare earth mineralized areas. And there's some, you know, clearly defined anomalous zones of mineralization. And, you know, some of those might have individual sort of prospects within them. So I think it speaks to the project-wide potential for rare earth mineralization here.
And we're talking a high proportion of heavy rare earths, which is encouraging.
Yeah, that's the point of difference, I think, for the Mount Squires project. Those heavy rare earths are about 4 to 5 times more valuable than your light rare earths. So, you know, we're still trying to work out what's an economic sort of grade of mineralization. But I can tell you that if those, and it's encouraging that we are seeing the same proportion of heavies to lights, whether it be in our drilling or our rock chips. And if that continues, you know, anything getting close to 1% is going to be a great kind of number.
Well, of course, you've got this upcoming RC drill program due to commence mid-June. What's the plan there?
Yeah, so about mid-June, RC rig arrives on site as it was originally scheduled. Probably the only change is now that we're going to be drilling the rare earth targets first, so stepping out from away from the original discovery hole 141. And then, of course, leading into our other gold targets and nickel and copper targets. So it's probably looking at maybe about a 4,000 to 5,000 meter program. There's something for everybody out there at the moment. There's so little downside to this project at the moment. It's unbelievable.
You say you'll be looking to get some samples here for some early stage metallurgical test work also.
Yeah, that's right. So I think it's really important on the rare earth front to actually understand where your mineralization sits. And so we're doing some early stage mineralogy, and which is already happening now. But then we'll also follow up with this RC program to collect some samples that we can do some more thorough met test work. And then we'll really know where we stand on that front.
Good to see you, Greg. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.